Hi children, how are you? In the last class, we discussed about lesson A Treat for Mosquitoes. Okay children, in this class we completed up to page number 72. Okay, I hope you practice those questions. Okay, now in this class, we will move on to textual questions in page number 73. Okay children, okay, in the last class, so see here, page number 72, think, okay ma, what do you think it talks about putting fish in the tank? What do you think the fish eats? Okay children, you already know about this. Okay, what we have in dirty water? One see wells, baga path padipoyina 20 chinna chinna cherulu. So definitely we observe something in the water. What is that? Okay, so that is called green algae. Padaina chusara water anta green color lo kanipistundi kada? Yes, that is called algae. Okay, here the question is, what do you think it talks about putting fish in the tank? What do you think the fish eats? Okay, so here it talks about putting fish in the tank because the fish eats larva of mosquito developing in water. Okay, why we are putting fish in the tanks? Why? Because here the fish eats the larva of mosquitoes. Okay, then what happened? Automatically, the mosquito population will be reduced. Okay, children, this is the one of the way to reduce the mosquito's population. Okay, next, second one, what will happen when oil is spread on the water? What happened? So, see here, when oil is spread on water, its thin layer on water surface prevents oxygen supply to eggs and larva mosquitoes due to which they are killed. Here what happened? Here the oil or kerosene, it forms a layer on the surface of water. Here this oil surface reduces the supply of oxygen. Then what happened? Here we couldn't get sufficient amount of oxygen, then what happened? Not only mosquitoes, we cannot survive. Okay, so this is the one of the way. Okay children, when oil is spread on the water, it's a thin layer on water surface prevents oxygen supply to eggs and larva of mosquitoes due to which they are killed. Okay ma? Now, page number 73, find out. Which diseases are spread by flies and how? Flies means house flies, eagle. Okay, the answer is, the following diseases are spread by flies. Dysentery, cholera, typhoid, etc. When a fly sits on contaminated material, okay, harmful germs stick to its legs. When the same fly sits on the food, the germs get transferred to the food. Thus, a fly spreads various diseases. Are you understood? Yes. One see in rainy season. Okay, what happened? For example, in summer season, when we eat any mango, then what happened? Immediately, flies will come. Is it right or wrong? Yes. Okay. So, here they move to other places. And they are roaming in other places. Not only healthy conditions. Dump yards, dryness, water. Okay. So, such type of places visited. Okay. Then what happened? The harmful germs stick to its legs. Okay. So when it sits on the food material, the germs will transfer to its legs to the fodder. So like that we get diseases. Okay children, now see here, mosquito check. This is in page number 73. Once you observe the page and you have to follow the answers. Okay children, here the first question. What is that? Here the question is, divide your class into two or three groups. Each group will go around to check one area in school or around it. It must carefully note if water has collected anywhere and mark a tick mark where it finds stagnant water. Okay. So nowadays the situations are not good. That's why don't go to any other places. I will give you answers. Please copy in your textbook. Okay children. Okay. You see here the first one. Pot, cooler, tank, any open space in the school ground, gutter, or any other place. Here the question is, since how many days has water collected there? Okay, next. Who is responsible for keeping these places clean? Who is supposed to get the gutters and the drains repaired? Okay, ma'am. Next, can any larva be seen in the collected water? Okay, here, has it caused any problem in the area? Right. Okay, here you have to write the answers. So from where you collect water, if you get water, if you collected water from pots, coolers, tanks, anywhere, you have to just tick mark. Here I will give you. Okay children. So just note down in your textbook. The first one is, since how many days has water collected there? The water seems to have been collected there from more than a week. For more than a week. Okay. Now second one, who is responsible for keeping these places clean? Okay. So within the school, the school authorities are responsible for cleanliness, and outside the school, municipal authority is responsible. Okay children. Now, third one, who is supposed to get the gutters and drains repaired? Gutter means waste. Okay. Here the answer is, the municipality is supposed to get the gutters and drains repaired. Okay. So one municipal worker will come to our house and collect the gutter. Okay, not only in our house, schools, offices, anywhere. Okay children, and they only repair the drains. Okay, now fourth one, can any larva be seen in the collected water? Yes, we could see mini larva in the collected water. Sometimes we also observe in tap water also. Okay. So why? Because here the drain water will mix it with the pipes. That's why we have to observe in tap water also. Okay children. Now, has it caused any problem in the area? The answer is yes. There are many problems in the area. The area looks quite dirty. Mosquitoes and flies keep swarming around the area. Okay, so when they poured in particular area, see dump yards, how it is, it causes many problems, health problems, mosquitoes, flies, everyone. It looks very dirty, and from the dump yard we get some bad smell also. So by the smell definitely we get diseases. Okay, next, in your group, we keep posted with a message to keep the cooler, tank, drains and the area clean. Okay, so here these are the places wherever collected water. Okay children, so Here this is the posture. Why? Because these are the breeding sites for mosquitoes. That's why we have to clean these areas, cooler, tanks, drains, whatever it is, dump yards, whatever it is, we have to clean it regularly. Okay children, this is the posture. Okay, next, find out who is responsible for keeping the area around your school clean. Write a letter from your class reporting your findings and suggestions. Find out to whom the letter should be written and to which office it should be sent. Okay children, okay, here the answer is the municipality of our town is responsible for keeping the area around our school clean. Okay, who is responsible? For example, in our school, IAS will collect the waste from our class. Okay, so our management puts big bins. Okay, so out of the school, the IAS will take the entire waste and pour it in the outside dustbins. Okay, municipal workers will come and collect the waste. Okay, what happened if they didn't collect the waste from our bins? So it gives bad smell, it decomposed, then automatically diseases will spread. Okay, so here who is responsible for that? So municipality is responsible for that work. Okay, so if they didn't come and they didn't collect the waste, means we have to write the letter. The letter should be written to the ward counselor of the ward in which our school comes. First we have to write the letter for ward counselor. Okay, the letter should be sent to the municipal office. Okay children, so here we have to write the a letter for ward counselor. They send the letter to the municipal office. Who is responsible for that? So sanitary inspector is responsible for that. Okay children, okay. Now next one, is there a pond or river around your house or school? Go and look around and observe these things. Okay, nowadays situations are not good, that's why don't go anywhere. I will give you answers. Okay, so observe these questions and listen carefully. Okay, here the first question, can you see algae in or around the water? The answer is yes, we can see algae in or around the water. See here how it is very green in color. Okay, we have to observe in our houses also. Okay, so for example in rainy season, so what happened? Appo varam rojulu continuous ga varsham padutune undu anukondi ela untundi man chuttu man surroundings anni kuda manam fast ga nadchukunte vellam anukondi jaari padipotha kada. Yes, nammadiga nadu jaari potharu man parents kuda cheptu untaru kada. Yes, green color lo kanipistu untundi naach pattestundi ani cheptu untaru avuna. Yes, what is that? That is called algae. Okay children, we have to observe algae in our house and water bodies also. That's why the water appear green in color. Okay. Okay children. Now next one. Where else have you seen algae? We have seen algae on the surface of ponds, pools, near the drains and hand pumps. Okay. Now next one, are there plants growing on the side or in water? Find out their names. Yes, there are some small plants growing on the side or in the water. Okay, names of few plants are liverworts and mosses. Yes, so the water will appear green in color, that is called algae. Okay, some special kind of plants are also will grow on the water. Those are called aquatic plants. Okay, so here liverworts and mosses. So these are the plants growing on the side or in the water. What do we call these plants? These are called aquatic plants. They will grow in the water. Okay, now do you think these were planted by someone or did they grow on their own? All these plants grew on their own. No one couldn't plant it. They will grow on their own. Okay, now next one. What else can you see in water? Make a list. The answer is, we can also find small fishes, frogs, fronds, mosquito larva, and tiny insects floating in water. Okay, not only algae, some other things are. That means animals, other animals. We can find small fishes, frogs, plants, crabs, such kind of animals we have to observe on the water. Okay, children. Next. See here, page number 75, what we have learned. The first one is, what can you do so that mosquitoes do not breed in your house, school and neighborhood? That means what you have to do to reduce the mosquito population. Okay, here the answer is, we can prevent mosquitoes to breed by, how can we prevent? Not allowing water logging in the nearby areas. And the second one, spraying DDT and kerosene oil in drains, pits, etc. Okay, so here DDT means we call it what is that, white color lo spray chestar kada, bleaching powder antam kada mana. Yes, that is called DDT. Okay, so it reduces the mosquitoes population. Okay, now next one, cleaning the coolers and water tanks regularly. Why? Because these are the breeding sites for mosquitoes. That's why we have to clean coolers and water tanks regularly. By doing this, we have to reduce the mosquitoes population. Okay, now last one. So how can you find out if someone has malaria? How can we find out? A positive blood test to diagnose malaria will confirm that the person has malaria. That means simply blood test. We can find out so by the blood test. Okay, children. So I hope you understood these question and answers. Okay. So after watching this video, you have to read these question and answers. Okay. And copy in your CW. Okay, children. Thank you.